This is Ken Carpenter welcoming you to the Bing Crosby Show, transcribed from Hollywood.
Moonlight becomes you. It goes with your hair. You certainly know the right thing to wear.
Good evening, this is Bing Crosby. Buddy Cole, the boys, and I would like to serenade you right off with that old favorite entitled, Do Yous Ever Think of Me?
Be interested in hearing about an inspired tax collector tonight? After all, you know, it's soon going to be time for the annual pilgrimage, the mass migration to the nearest tax collector's office. Step lively, please, now. Come along. That's good. Come on now. Anyhow, the imaginative tax man that I refer to is collector Alvin D. Hatton of Kansas City. This fellow's instituted the use of music in his offices. He hopes that this attraction will have a soothing effect on taxpayers when they pay their taxes. You know, this could be a genuine stride in the right direction. After all, scientists and medical men have been continually striving to develop new drugs to ease pain, and I guess it's high time that tax collectors come up with their own brand of Novocaine to give people when they put the bite on them. Music, you know, might be the answer, might be the antidote. Music's been used in many instances for its therapeutic values, even to the extent of piping it into hen houses to increase the egg yield. This, of course, is considered by economists as a sneaky way to get pullets to overmatch themselves. Might even, therefore, indicate that music for taxpayers would be used for the same purposes, but I don't think so. I'm sure the intentions of our tax collectors would have only the people's comfort in mind. If Collector Hatton's experiment proves successful, and music is adopted by the Bureau of Internal Revenue, the paying of taxes should no longer be an ordeal of coming in to face the music. Rather, it'll be a time to come in and hear it. The use of music might also induce the taxpayer to dig a bit deeper into his pockets. Put him in a more mellow and expansive mood, sort of lull him into liberality. If so, it seems that if dulcet tones are wafted through the air conditioning ducts of the tax offices, it'll be a great improvement over the usual methods of persuasion. Implements such as the rubber hose, the rack, the bed of nails, and the Oregon spike booth will be outmoded. These instruments of the Inquisition will be replaced by the jukebox and the recording turntable. Of course, there'll be problems, bound to be. One of which will be what type of music to play. And this is important, since the musical tastes of each individual taxpayer are going to vary. The nerves of a person who likes pastorals might be shattered if the needle is dropped on the recording of a bebop. And of course, a Frank Sinatra fan might tear up his 1040 form in a fit of temper if a Frankie Lane rendition is played, or vice versa. But I'm sure the musical director of the Internal Revenue Department, and they're going to have one, I'm sure, he'll take this into consideration. It could be solved, for instance, by an additional query which could be added to the questionnaire of our tax form, such as, what type of music do you prefer, old boy? Having this advanced knowledge, your tax office will be all ready when you stagger in, loaded down with your bundle of notes, exemptions, and alleged deductions. I know that a certain kind of song has a marked effect on a friend of mine by the name of Pat O'Brien, a very fine actor and a taxpayer emeritus. Pat, as who wouldn't know, is a devotee of any tune with a tinge of emerald, anything with an Irish lilt to it. Or when he hears the tune where the River Shannon flows, his tear ducts do the same thing. The old song Kathleen Mavourneen has a much more soothing effect on Pat than, well, let us say Shaboom or something like that. With so many Irish tunes to choose from, I can see no reason why the tax collectors should have any trouble with any irascible Hibernians. There can be no doubt that if the music is to their liking, any wearers of the green will happily hand over their green on April the 15th. And there's those of Scottish descent. Now, lots of jokes have been made up about the frugality of the Scot. But I'm sure that Angus doesn't cry out in anguish any louder than the rest of us when it comes time to pay our taxes. Music would help assuage us all, I'm sure, and a citizen of Scottish descent would be within his rights to call the Internal Revenue disc jockey and request a bagpipe rendition. The capitals are coming, hooray, hooray. An appropriate tune, don't you think, to greet him when he walks through the door, followed by all the other little Campbells to prove that he does have that many dependents. But for those taxpayers who have no particular choice of music or type of song, tone-deaf jokers, why, new material will have to be written for them. This might open up a whole new field for the tunesmiths of Tin Pan Alley. Or perhaps a rehash of some old songs to make them more appropriate for the occasion. For example, the object of my affections could be changed very quickly into the object of my deductions. And the ballad, It's Only a Paper Moon, can be switched to, well, it's only a paper form. Now, for those who pay their taxes by cash instead of check, there's always the old favorite, Zing Went the Strings of My Pocketbook. There's even a song that I made a recording of back in 1946. Very big tax year for me, as I recall. I think it would be a fitting tune for those last-minute taxpayers, those tenacious diehards who hold off until the last minute. It's a song entitled, Now is the Hour. To lay it on the barrelhead. These are just a few, but the possibilities, as you can see, are absolutely limitless. There's no doubt that the use of music to anesthetize taxable citizens will have far-reaching effects. For instance, song pluggers, I can just see them swarming in front of the Internal Revenue offices, waving copies of their latest wares at people, hoping to get them to request a certain tune. This could very well, you know, snowball into an unhappy situation for the publishers and the composers of these songs, since by collecting additional fees and royalties, they might be zoomed into a higher income bracket. However, I'm sure the tax collectors would have only the sedative side of music in mind, and not as a source of additional income to balance the budget. They couldn't possibly do that. Music in many forms has been used to entice the populace in some direction or other. It's the Pied Piper gimmick adapted commercially. You know, good humor hucksters use it to advantage. Supermarkets offer tinkling tunes when the frozen food compartment is opened. Canned music with canned goods, so to speak. And there was a time in radio when a deluge of music quiz shows were foisted on the listening public. Many were the opportunities to pick up an easy dollar if one had the patience, a telephone, and could guess the right tune when the music was stopped or started or something or other. times have changed somewhat, and most of that get-rich-quick crowd have got themselves Geiger counters. They're out searching for uranium. Instead of sitting home waiting for the buzz of their telephones, they're out of doors waiting for the buzz of their Geigers. Personally, I'm all for music while parting with dough. If we have to pay through the nose, then let us have the opportunity of listening with the ear to our favorite rhapsody, operetta, schottische, or Dixieland band. At least when a taxpayer is asked by his tax examiner what's the score, he's not going to be referring to the amount due the government. He merely wants to know what kind of music is desired during the conference. I may even get behind this whole musical movement for the peace of mind of the American taxpayer and contribute a stack of my recording. Or do you think that would be adding a pill to the cup of hemlock? Anyhow, to audition for you. Here's a sample of my work. Let me know if I soothe you, will you? Carry on with that nice thought, I'd like to say that I hope we all meet again. What do you say, right here, same time, the same place tomorrow evening? Good night, and thank you very much.
Be sure to tune in again tomorrow night to Bing Crosby with Buddy Cole and his group, transcribed from Hollywood.